So these mesenchymal stem cells with their magic soup and those little vesicles that release the soup into the body and into the organ that's damaged, etc. What are these? What is the outcome of this soup of cytokines that is released? Number one, a reduction of inflammation, a massive reduction of inflammation. Now, this is really important because most of our chronic diseases that we all know of, we all heard about them, have as a part of their fundamental element a systemic inflammation of our body. It may only be your joints that are hurting because you have rheumatoid arthritis, but you have, in fact, a massive systemic inflammation throughout your body because of this rheumatoid arthritis. And the magic soup that the stem cells release immediately reduces inflammation at its source throughout your entire body. So let me give you an example again using rheumatoid arthritis. The drugs that you hear advertised all the time on TV, Enbrel and Humira, they in fact target the markers that you'll find in someone's body, in their blood, that are inflammatory markers showing how much inflammation is going on in their body. And in people with rheumatoid arthritis or other inflammatory diseases, those markers are really high where they shouldn't be. So you take the Enbrel and Humira, and after a certain amount of time, usually numerous weeks, slowly but surely, they will suppress those markers. But those drugs have very serious and many serious side effects that are not good for us. On the other hand, if you give that patient an infusion of stem cells, within hours, a day or two at most, those same inflammatory markers get reduced by like 50%. And there's absolutely no downtime, no side effects, no detrimental elements like there are for those pharmaceuticals. And if you give them a second dose, their markers will go down another 50%. So this is powerful medicine. And these are the stem cells are the ones that bring it, that release that medicine into our bodies. Number two on the list are autoimmune diseases, diseases where our immune system has gone haywire and causing all sorts of havoc in our body. Now, many of these diseases we're very familiar with, things such as rheumatoid arthritis, multiple sclerosis, lupus, IBD or inflammatory bowel disease, even type 1 diabetes, you may not know, is also an autoimmune disease. Psoriasis, which is a skin disease, even asthma has autoimmune elements to it. And various thyroid dysfunctions are also autoimmune. Now there's a whole nother class of diseases that have immune dysfunction associated with them that are not exactly autoimmune, but still stem cells work for them as well. And these include diseases where you have a chronic persistent infection that then causes the immune system to get overreactive because it can never calm down because the body is infected and the infection doesn't go away. Things like Lyme's disease is a perfect example of that. Or herpes, viruses such as herpes or HIV, these fall into that category as well. Now, to understand how stem cells help in diseases such as these, we first have to review briefly how the immune system is supposed to work. So, what happens? We have these immune cells, these lymphocyte, white blood cells are often called, and they are designed to react to invaders coming into our body. So, take a look at this slide. We have a cell. It is waiting around to be activated. It is properly activated when a virus or bacteria or some kind of invader comes into our body, which causes the cell to become activated, as you can see. Now, once it's activated, it's going to expand. In other words, it's going to duplicate itself and create a small army of other cells that are activated to fight that one pathogen, that one invader that started this whole cascade going. Now, this is a very, very specific function. It is highly controlled because you don't want to get this thing going out of control. And it's going to then fight the invader that has come into the body. And you'll see that these cells that expanded, this little army of cells, are releasing a whole bunch of special biochemical moderators that are going to fight the infection and attack the infection. Some of these biochemicals are, in fact, inflammatory biochemicals. It is an inflammation that is necessary. Most people think inflammation is always bad. That's not true. Our bodies need to have inflammation in order to do all sorts of important functions, including the immune system fighting pathogens. So, quickly, in sum, when this is a controlled, very specific system, it will deal with invaders without going out of control and hurting things or attacking things that aren't the invaders. In an autoimmune condition or an autoimmune disease, we have our immune white cells, lymphocytes, that are waiting to be activated, but in this case, they are activated improperly, abnormally, aberrantly, not by an invading bacterium or virus, but by our own tissues. Something in our tissues has activated the cell. And the cell then goes through this massive clonal expansion. Billions of these cells are created in our body, and all of them are releasing these inflammatory biochemicals that are causing the disease state in our tissues, are attacking our organs, such as in diabetes. It's attacking our own pancreas and causing us to lose the ability to make insulin. Or they're attacking the cartilage in our joints and creating rheumatoid arthritis and deformation of our joints and all that pain that you see. Now, in traditional Western medicine, we have these pharmaceutical drugs that will work on helping us contain the inflammation that we've been talking about. A great example is rheumatoid arthritis, the drugs Humira and Enbrel. So how do those pharmaceutical drugs work? They will target those lymphocyte, those immune cells, and clamp on them, and inhibiting their ability to release those inflammatory lymphokine biochemicals. The drugs will also target those inflammatory biochemicals themselves. They will inactivate them. Right? Now, again, it takes a number of weeks for this to take place, but there's a problem because it's clamping down not just on these cells, the ones, the aberrant cells that are attacking our tissues, they're clamping down on all the immune cells. So now your immune functions, your natural, necessary, important immune functions are being suppressed throughout your body, which makes you susceptible to other diseases and infections. This is not a good thing. Now, let's look at stem cells and see how they deal with this autoimmune inflammatory disease situation. They will attack the situation right at the source. Instead of waiting down to the bottom of that slide where all that inflammatory and biochemicals are released by the immune army, by that clonal army, they will go up to the top where that aberrant activation occurs, and they will stop the whole system from going out of control where that clonal army is created. They essentially heal the problem at its source. So instead of just managing the disease and trying to manage the inflammation, as pharmaceutical drugs do with all of their many negative side effects, stem cells will essentially cure the disease where it starts. We don't exactly understand how they do this. There's still much about this that is mysterious to us. But the fact is, they do it. So if you're suffering from any of those long list of diseases that have autoimmune issues or autoimmune components to them, or massive inflammation because of a chronic infection, stem cells could very well be your solution. So again, number one, reduce inflammation. Number two, modulate autoimmune dysfunction. Number three, stimulate regeneration. Well, we've been talking about that all along, and sure enough, If you have a damaged organ or a damaged tissue and you insert these mesenchymal stem cells into that damaged organ or tissue, it starts to regenerate. In fact, it can completely regenerate. That's, for instance, why stem cells, these stem cells, can cure a person from diabetes. So instead of taking insulin for the rest of your life, you just cure your pancreas with stem cells and you don't have to take the insulin anymore. I'm an example of something very similar. I had a very damaged knee. I had 11 knee surgeries. And last year I was due for a total knee replacement because I had completely worn out all the articular cartilage, the cartilage that are on those bones in that joint. I was bone on bone. My whole knee became very, deformed because of that. And it was excruciatingly painful. So I was due for a total knee replacement. Instead, we injected my knee with these mesenchymal stem cells from an umbilical cord. 6 months later, I had completely regenerated my articular cartilage, and this July, I'm climbing Mount Kilimanjaro. Now, this is not an isolated case. Shoulders, knees, elbows, major athletes. Kobe Bryant flew to Germany to get the stem cells in his knee because he couldn't get them here. That's a political issue. We won't talk about that. Now we can actually do this kind of work, and the results are magnificent. Number four, one of the questions that many people have about these stem cells, hey, these stem cells came out of someone else's body. True. So if you take tissue from someone else's body and insert it in my body, aren't I going to have an immune response, a rejection of those things? You've heard, of course, that sometimes people have to match. For instance, if someone needs a kidney transplant, you have to match that kidney, the donor, with the kind of cell membranes that you have in your body so that when you insert that kidney, you don't reject it. When you reject a transplanted tissue, the reaction of your immune system is intense, and that, in fact, can kill you, let alone not having a functioning kidney. It's called graft versus host disease. Well, as a matter of fact, these mesenchymal stem cells from the umbilical cord don't have the cell, components, the cell wall components that cause those kind of reactions. They are what they call immune privileged, so that you can put them in anybody and the other person doesn't get a reaction to them. In fact, their ability to modulate immune response is so powerful that not only do you not reject them, but if you're in the middle of rejecting some other, tissue that you've had transplanted, like a kidney, and you're in the middle of that of the terrible chaos of a graft versus host disease, if they infuse those stem cells in you, those stem cells will calm that reaction down, and you'll be able to keep the kidney usually, okay, and you'll be cured of that graft versus host reaction. And last but not least, many people are concerned, well, will those stem cells grow a tumor in me? Well, no, they won't. And this is one of the things that the FDA required a great deal of research on to be sure that these stem cells don't promote cancer. And in fact, it's been proven that not only do they not grow cancer, they actually will kill tumors, cancerous tumors. And this too, there's a lot of research on this. And by the way, at the end of this lecture, you'll see some links that you can go to for additional information. So where do we use them? Here are the three areas: the inflammation, the autoimmune, and the regeneration. Under inflammation, heart disease, by the way, heart disease is always associated with vascular inflammation. And that's a whole topic for another lecture. Liver disease, diabetes, autism, the inflammation of your vasculature also causes strokes. So there's an element of inflammation and getting strokes. In the case of autism, again, that's a talk or a subject for another presentation. Just know, though, that autism is associated with massive GI or intestinal inflammation. And if you give the stem cells to a child who's suffering from autism, even a young adult who's suffering from autism, the inflammation in the GI goes away, and the symptoms and the characteristics of autism start healing, and it can be very dramatic. The autoimmune column we've spoken about, rheumatoid arthritis, MS, Parkinson's, Duchenne muscular dystrophy, not necessarily associated with autoimmune, it's more of a genetic disorder. Well, guess what? Stem cells not only arrest the progression of the muscular dystrophy, it can even heal it. It's just incredible, the magic that happens with stem cell therapy. Regeneration, joints, spinal cords, brain strokes, the list is endless. But let me simply say that one of the most dramatic examples is when someone is paralyzed because they've had a spinal cord severed. And the prime example is a commercial pilot who was in an accident, severed his spinal cord, became quadriplegic, obviously lost his license to fly. The stem cell treatment was done on his spine, and a few months later, full function regained, got his license back, and is flying airplanes again. So this kind of thing just, was the stuff of fantasy, and now it's real, it's actually happening.